Steve, it's Heart Health Month, and this morning's topic is not one about the telltale signs of a heart attack, but another issue that's often mistaken for one. I'm here with MedStar Health cardiologist Dr. Syed Haider. Thank you so much for joining us. And today we're talking about pericarditis. Describe to me what it is and what the signs are.
Thanks for having me today, Marissa. Pericarditis is basically an irritation of the lining of the heart. So the heart is essentially a muscle which is surrounded by a layer called pericardium. It's an important layer to have because it's protecting your heart from various pathogens and foreign bodies. And it's also providing you some protection against friction. Pericarditis is a disease which basically entails an irritation or inflammation of that lining and can lead to debilitating chest pain and some other complications such as fluid buildup around the heart.
And that's when it feels like a heart attack.
That's exactly right. It does feel like a heart attack. In fact, that's an excellent segue into our discussion that many patients who present to the emergency room with pericarditis symptoms are often mistaken as if they were having a heart attack, and rightly so. However, it is only when you rule out heart attack that you should be looking into whether pericarditis may be present or not. They both share a lot of classic features such as chest pain. Both heart attack and pericarditis will initially present with patients will say, I'm having the worst chest pain of my life. And their EKG changes, which is basically a graphic voltage representation of the heart. Both pericarditis and heart attack can have some overlap in how they both present, and that's when it gets a little bit challenging to diagnose it.
Well, what are the outcomes then of pericarditis, and how are they different from a heart attack?
That's an excellent question, Marissa. In general, as we know, when patients do get ruled in for heart attack, the typical way to manage them would be if there's an artery that's clogged, you open it. Pericarditis is different in that in the emergency room, there's not much to do except tell the patients, you know, you may be having pericarditis, but a lot of times it gets missed. And that's where the outcomes come, because a lot of times patients are reassured you're not having a heart attack, but they go home with this chest pain for several months to years, and it can get unrelenting. It can get debilitating. So the outcomes become worse the longer it gets undiagnosed.
Or misdiagnosed. So how can you then, I guess, reduce your risk? And then on top of that, what are the treatments?
That's a great question. The first thing we need to do is have a good index of suspicion. So when patients come to the emergency room, and what we tell our colleagues and other providers is have that on your differential. Once heart attack has been ruled, that's great. It has been ruled you're not having a heart attack, but the work doesn't end there. Try to look for alternative causes of chest pain, and have an index of suspicion, and where necessary, refer them to a cardiologist. Do the necessary testing. Now, there are about 2 to 4 clinical criteria that you can use to diagnose pericarditis, such as the absence of classic chest pain, which is described as pain that gets worse with taking deep breaths or when you're laying flat, the presence of fluid around the heart, and some other EKG changes and certain exam findings. But I often find that patients may just have one of them, and that's when it gets challenging to diagnose. So have an index of suspicion, and to reviewers who are listening to us, you know, listen to your body, listen to your symptoms, and know that if you're having these symptoms that aren't getting better, there are therapies that are available. In fact, it's an excellent time to be talking about pericarditis because we have new biologic agents, interleukin-1 inhibitors that we did not have 5 years ago. So I feel this is an excellent opportunity for viewers to listen to their bodies, to talk to their providers that, yes, chest pain has been ruled out, but what is wrong with me? Why do I keep having this chest pain?
And we know that pericarditis can lead to other heart and bodily issues, too, if not cared for at the onset. Thank you so much. We didn't have enough time to get into all of that, but I think you got the point across is, listen, if you're having an issue, don't sit on it. See a doctor as soon as possible. And for that, I appreciate you.
Thank you, Marissa.
MedStar Health cardiologist Dr. Syed Haider, thanks for sharing.
Thank you, Marissa.